One of the things we do here at GNS Science is measure air quality. Today what I'm going to do is show you how we do this. So all we've got is a vacuum cleaner that's going to pull air through the filter, and then we're going to take that filter and do some measurements on it. I'm going to hold it up for 10 minutes and that should be enough. I've got another one here which I'm going to use to test motor vehicle emissions. Alright, I think we've caught enough here. You can see on the end of that, it's slightly tinged grey with the particles on there. This time we're going to test what's in wood smoke. First I've got to make a fire just like you do at home during the winter to heat your house. So now we've got our three samples, fresh air, motor vehicle and our wood smoke. Now I'm going to show you what we do next. I'm going to analyse them using our instrumentation. My colleague Bill is going to tell you exactly how we go about doing that.
From here we take these filters and we can put them in our chamber and we can illuminate them with a beam of protons which can tell us the elemental composition of the air pollution on the filters and the concentration of those particulates. As you can see, there is a lot of different elements that occur in our air pollution, and these concentrations vary throughout a day or depending on where we're sampling or what sources are being active at a particular point in time. So this is the first sample that Perry collected. Even though it looks very clean, we'll still have a lot of background elements and sources of air particles on it. And air particles like wind-blown sea salt, it will have some nearby dust that's from the roads, from the traffic, and we'll still have other elements that we can detect with our machine. The second one that Perry collected was from the exhaust of the motor vehicle, and again, while this still, you can see it's a little bit grey, still has some smoke air pollution on it with some of the other elements like sulfur that we can detect with our machine. But the worst one was the one from the smoke, and this is typical of what we might see of air filters that are collected on cold winter nights when we burn wood in our homes to stay warm.
In actual fact, we use monitoring stations around the country using a little bit more sophisticated equipment than a vacuum cleaner, but the same principle.
So generally New Zealand has very clean air, but there are occasions and there are locations around New Zealand where the air is not so clean. The more information we have about sources of air pollution, the more we can do to control and to mitigate those.
So you've seen how we monitor air pollution, how we measure it, and where it comes from, and at what time of the day, and using that information, we can improve the air quality of our cities and towns and make New Zealand a better place to live.